All right, you're done. Let's take a look at the solution. Now we're going to need some text views. First of all, let's look at our linear layout. It's vertical. We're going to want it to be horizontal. The next thing we're going to want are a bunch of text views. Let's just drag them in. Now remember, we had all those IDs that were given to us in the last quiz. The first one is the list, item, date, text view. And we'll give it some text that makes sense when we help to lay out the layout. We'll remove this before we actually submit it to our project. And for fun, let's switch to landscape. It'll make things a little bit more legible. Also, let's just zoom in a little bit. All right. So that's our list item date text view. Now, right next to that, we want another text view. Since we want the design to be the same, this one doesn't need to have an ID. If you remember, our design had the date, followed by a dash, followed by the forecast, followed by a dash, followed by the high, followed by a slash, followed by low. So this is just going to be a view that contains a dash. And we can even hard code this in for now. Then we're going to create another text view next to that. Our placeholder text will be a forecast, like clear. The ID for this one will be list item forecast text view. Now we need another text view. Once again, this one's not going to have an ID because we don't need it. And we'll add another dash. Now we're actually getting to the high and low forecasts. Let's say a high of 23. One more plain text view, this one with a slash, and once again with no ID. And for our high forecast, it better be list item high text view. Finally, we'll add one more plain text view. This one will be for our low, and of course, that means it's going to be list item low text view. And there we have it, our multiple text view layout. Now we might want to make this prettier. Well, this is a good start, and it displays the four fields we were asked for. They're all part of a linear layout. Before we actually would submit this, let's remove the placeholder text for everything except for the static fields. We'll also have to remove these empty IDs. It's actually important to understand what's going on in these text views. And there we have it. That's what your layout should look like. At least if you want to make it look almost identical to the layout we started out with. Of course, you can go wild with these designs, and there's a lot you can do with the layout editor and with different kinds of layouts. We'll be learning more about that in the next lesson. All right, we finally get to start hooking this up to our UX. Let's go back to forecast fragment.